not quite sure where all this shit is, but doesn't matter. Back to it. That thing has to die. Well, I'll just dance around in front of this thing for a bit and let you get your ass back in gear. Thank you. Yeah, I'm not gonna take that until I know where it's going. Anything? Bueller? No? Okay, well I know where that goes. Here, yep. Still haven't found the other two rune urns, I guess, but they should be here soon. Nope, can't make that jump. This is a fun walk. I put music on, but unfortunately it's all going to be copyright protected, so YouTube is going to want to crack at it. So you'll have to just settle for my dulcet tones, which I still have no idea what that word even means, dulcet. I've heard it used so often that now I just know the context and use it in that situation. It's pretty hot in here actually, I'll see if I get some water in me. Bitter squirrel to unearth consumables. You gotta be fucking kidding me with that. It basically just summons health. Upgrade armor. Interesting. Found only at the layoff outpost. Okay, this is the only place I can ever get that. What the hell did that even do? In a fight. Yep. Oh good, three of them.
I'm ready.
Okay. How about the beach? Is it on the beach? No. Okay. Yet another realm tear we have to look at later. Now, onward to quest objectives.
That's an interesting gate. I wonder who built it.
Right, back under the bridge.
Ed, you are full of stories. When will you tell one that entertains?
I beg your pardon?
He just insulted you.
Yeah, I got that. So you want a corker, do you? Very well, my brothers. I'll tell you the story of Runia, the brawler. The real story.
There was a huge battle, right? His shrine had him in the middle, fighting off Aesir.
A pretty story, but no. Runia, you see, was born with neither head nor heart. So the giants had to complete him with stone. He was strong, to be sure, but also a perfect simpleton. Odin met him wandering in Midgard one day, found him so amusing, so harmless, so gullible, that he invites him back to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Hrungnir his fill of mead, and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. I was there. I saw the Aesir laugh as Hrungnir leapt upon his shield and swore he'd kill us all and take our womenfolk back to Jotunheim. Then Thor shows up. And does he laugh? Oh no. Thor takes one look at the drunken stone buffoon and brings down Mjolnir on his head so hard that he's got chunks of Hrungnir in his own skull to this day. Thor is so startled by the faceful of rock. He doesn't notice Hrungnir's body topple right onto him with a sickening crunch. And again, the roars of laughter echo through the palace halls.
That's an awful story, Mimir. Nothing like the ones Mother told me.
Let that be a lesson, my son. Truth is seldom so pretty as myth and legend.
Alright, that gave me plenty of time to check my phone, so I'm grateful for that. And we got enemies coming up. Oh, that's not an enemy at all.
You were taken from this realm too early.
Let's talk to what's his name.
You who walks among the living. My beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace.
Is she pissed if somebody named her Gulvig?
I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
That's much better.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
Well, we're gonna track that.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Alright, well that is... I mean, this is definitely the,
Good! The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Yeah, that's definitely the what the... Oh, what the fuck now? Aren't you all very unlucky, because now I have a troll.
Bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's heritage.
He said as he pushes the bones out to go look for bones. Sorry, boat. God, really? Wow, Rocky, good job. Oh, man. You know what? Hang on a second. Alright, well, the first one's not too far away according to the map. Right up here, in fact.
Pulse with magic.
It must be Golvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
This spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
I can't tell which one's closer. I can't read those numbers from here. I'm gonna bank on this one.
We can beach over here.
Bothar.
Really?
Frim. Eric.
Are you okay?
My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined.
Okay, that's actually not too bad, but
thunderstorm scattered we're currently all three in the middle of my ships of across the lake. I know not what I...
Interesting. Oh, I actually did kill him. Okay.
Boy. Over here.
Yes, sir. It's another one of those maps.
Okay, so now we got a new map to check out. We've got two more bones to pull up, and then three more Hellwalker groups, I guess, to kill. There's a lot going on here. Okay, well that goes up further, but the bones are right here.
Golvi's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Golvi?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
This is gonna end very, very sadly, I'm pretty sure. Oh, we have enemies?
Wolver!
Oh, shit. Thank you. Oh, I'm curious how this goes. Okay, I gotta be honest, that's like mostly all of it's done right there. Oh god, I'm gonna do it again. Why am I doing it again? No, puppy, no!
I think you got him. Is it me? How are they getting tougher to beat?
Okay, what time was that? Because fuck, I want that recording. 1:43. Discovered
opportunities for hunting and trade in these lands. I gave up my search for Jotunheim long.
What would you say?
Nothing.
Nothing?
There is nothing left to say.
What about everything we've done so far? That man coming to the house? Talking to the world serpent? We've done so many amazing things. I just want to tell her about it.
Man, fuck that island.
What else would you say to her?
I tell her that we're both okay. Not to worry about us.
Atreus, I miss her too. You know this.
I thought I knew very little.
He's got you there, asshole. Okay, we've been here already. That's good. Okay, we got them all.
The final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. I just... Never mind.
Kratos almost gave him false hope for a second there, which is really surprising for him. I mean, granted, I'm still happy about it, like, that he was at least somewhat nice about it, but... Okay, what are the rewards here? Tears, Curious, must be. Oh yeah, it's part of the tier. Oh, these are both Tears armor recipes. It's more of the fact that I didn't give a shit about Tears armor anymore. This might actually be important.
I wonder why these bones are all over the place.
Desecration, typically. Pieces of scattered corpse make for a piss poor soul. No hope for Valhalla or Helheim when your arm's on one beach and your feet's on another.
Why not ask the spirit? I'm sure he will be forthcoming with answers.
I almost sense sarcasm in his voice there. Okay. It's good that all three are showing up in the same direction on the compass. It means that I'm not going to have to go very far to track them all down. The reason I'm not returning the bones right now is because, quite honestly, seeing as how that's the direction we're going to be going anyway to fulfill the quest line, we can afford to take a detour and then come back. Okay, I think we're in the right place. Not a kill, but...
It'll be alright.
was part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you?
Hang on a second. That squirrel might actually come in handy here.
Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
Now, as a matter of fact, I was scoffing at this thing a second ago, but I might actually pay to upgrade this thing, if only because if I can get 3 consumables per use, then that would go a long way towards, after fights I can heal myself, as opposed to having to die every time. How are we doing for... Okay, we got 17,000. Okay, so all of Atreus' abilities unlocked, all of the Guardian Shield and Rage Combat abilities unlocked. Just waiting on the last upgrade for the Leviathan Axe, and if I knew how much these things cost, I could actually budget my XP accordingly, and then I could know when I could stop worrying about having to upgrade my luck. Once I can stop putting things into luck and start putting them into strength, oh man, everything dies. Oh shit. Oh, fuck off! I can't block any of this shit! I'm not hit them with anything else. Okay. I was not expecting them to be able to stun lock me to death, but here we are. So the Hellwalkers, these ones in particular, are they just immune to axe attacks? Is that what's happening? Well, let's try this out again. Yeah, it seems like my attack is bouncing off without doing any real damage. I'll switch out your thing for the crows again. This time.
One captain leads so many men.
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all these men to their deaths.
True. But these men chose to follow. Even good leaders make poor choices. The best take responsibility for them. Remember this.
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
Can you read these, or am I just gonna stand here with it?
We've seen these runes
before.
Nope,
still can't. And this is...
But it's the kind I still can't read.
Is this gonna kill me? Yes, it is. Oh, good.
Come on.
still have no idea how much damage I'm actually going to take from these guys. I don't really want to risk it. Now I know. Instant kill. Oh boy. Still though, I was doing pretty well for a while there. I think maybe if I just pop my my rage, maybe once one of them is down to near almost dead, I can probably start doing damage to the other one. I know I'm cheesing this thing the hell out, but you know what? You didn't account for this strategy, it's not my fault. Traveler can figure this out. Next. Yeah, one more Hellwalker clue. One more Hellwalker clue. Not sure what turned the R into the L there, but whew. It's getting hot in here.
Father, were you ever a leader?
Many years ago, yes. I led men in battle.
Were you a good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you
ever... No more questions, boy. Focus on the task at hand.
Yes, sir.
One more Hellwalker crew, and then we got both objectives done. This is gonna be a fun one. Oh, fuck off!
Brother,
Okay, well, that at least covered the objective.
That was the last ship. I hope the captain will be satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never...
His head ended up inside the rock. That's great. Was there a tip for the Wolven? Or, yeah. If they aren't yet frenzied, they find out who gets a relentless approach. Okay, so it's all offense or all defense. That's the trick. Oh, fuck off. Yeah, no shit. Thanks, kid. Okay, if I can get the stun up, I can do a whole lot more damage to him that way. I'm not ready for this. I am nowhere near ready for this. One, maybe I could cheese it out, but not two. I can't do the axe throw cheese because they're just gonna dodge it over and over again. And I can't just circle around because there's two of them to deal with. It's gonna be a whole lot harder. What goals do we have now? Okay, we still need to get two more of those. But we can do both of these, so. I think these things gotta be respawning, because I'm coming through this area like two, three times, and every single time I come through, there's another one. You know what I bet that's for? I bet that's for if you spend all your upgrade points on something crappy, and then you want to upgrade, like, get something else instead. You can't count on the chest respawning, because that would just be way too easy. So you've got these things that respawn, and that's what gives you the ability to upgrade as much as you want if you're willing to just grind it out.
My men are...
That's right. We killed... We laid them all to rest.
Good save.
I see. So even in death, I am a failure.
But in life, you were honorable, strong-willed, and you inspired loyalty. These are good qualities, aren't they, boy?
Yeah. I couldn't believe how many men followed you here.
I thank you for your kind words. May your journey have a more pleasant end than mine.
So yeah, I give this offering to Tyr, which helps them with another piece of armor.
You didn't seem very satisfied.
Ironically, I am currently wearing the Tyr gauntlets.
Never.
And the only thing left would be the hope thing. I think I do have to stop to pick those up. You can just roll right through them. I'm thinking after a couple more upgrades, I might want to head back to Hell and take on the Challenge Tower again, since that's where I'm going to be. That's where I'm going to have to go to get my upgrades for the armor. Okay, let's hear it.
We have collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, O powerful Gulvig!
That didn't sound like...
She says she'll honor our request.
Eldifa.
I feel like she's gonna reunite us with our loved ones the bad way.
Okay.
That's adorable. Oh wow, she ain't shit. Oh, this is gonna hurt you more than it's gonna hurt me.
I told you so.
You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that was definitely something worth pointing out. So I guess desecrating remains is one explanation for scattering the corpse, also being that if these are, say, the components to summoning an evil spirit,
what is it?
You want to separate those two.
I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamu. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthor had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthor ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone.
Sadly, cool.
He caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty clawbag just got lucky.
Well, this thought would be interesting.
Hostiles.
Did you just say hostiles?
Ready if you are.
Or hostiles, but it still feels weird to me. Oh man, okay. Yeah, he's doing it again. It loses some impact the second time, but you know what? It's still real cool.
Magically sealed, I'm afraid.
Alright, we found almost all seven chambers. That's gotta be pretty interesting. Yeah, I bet you I know what this thing does. Go ahead and pop the other side while we're at it.
Neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea.
Oh, Sturdy Relic of Shadows. Is that the last door, or have we been here before?
What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
We'll need something to get through this one.
I guess that must be the same door, because it didn't tell me I got the last one. This place seems very familiar, and yet there's no possible way I could have been here before. Runic Wormskin Pauldrons. Not that I'm gonna wear it, but it's nice to know that I could. Oh boy.
There he is.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Up ahead, and I'll find Light Crystal. So what it's for. I'm set.
Can I open this? Oh, I guess not while we have a fight going on. There's the timing. Seven lights in the heavy. I don't know if that's audible on the microphone, but my stomach just did a 180. I don't know if it's a phrase, actually, if I just made some complete nonsense in my head, but it growled. It sounded like growl. Let's just go with that. Okay, more runic crap. Hey, some words written here.
What does it say?
Yes, sir. To Njord, we offer back the seas bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. So that they loved and worshipped him here.
No, I still see three symbols. Running out of storage space.